Yeah, we start with the last lecture about the complexities of the algorithm. The sorting algorithm is one of the algorithm which we need most of the cases. In the Google, Microsoft, they are always at the background. The 99% problem is sorting and then put it into a list and it is searching. I have already told the selection sort is one of the stupidest algorithm, but this is one of the because its base case is also O(n) squared, n is the number of item, and the worst case is O(n) squared. This is really tough. That is really stupid, and even the bubble sort, which is also a crude one, at least base case it is O(n), and that is it. Regarding this automata class, we try to find it out lot of things. We try to, because from your data structure class, you already come to know that complexity of the algorithm. And here in the automata class, we try to find it what is the end of traditional computing, okay, or traditional computing hardware. The traditional computing hardware is the most basic is finite state machine that we will discuss today. And the best book I prefer, that is the book, it is, I think that is visible, Michael Sipser. Michael Sipser's book is it is my favorite, and all the soft copies is available and given to you. For finite state machine, this Kohobi's book is the only one book I found it suitable. This is very good book, Kohobi, and it is also soft copies is available. And for language part, I found the Peter Lin's book is one of the best, Peter Lin's. Unfortunately, the soft copies is not available in the web. That is good. Another two books are very good. Another good is that is Harry Lewis, and I really tough. It is Papa Dimitru. This is also very good book for at least for entire automata. FSM PD is the best covered here in the Turing machine. That is one of the good book. This book is available in the library. That is one of the best book. And that is one good book. I found it really good. That is Kamala Krithivasan's book. It is also available. She is a professor in from IIT Chennai, and her lectures are video lectures are available on the NPTEL site. It is very good lectures, and also Shomnath Bisa's lectures also very good at IIT Kanpur. And this book is also very good, Kamala Krithivasan's book. Anyway, regarding the books I have told, these are the books I will cover, and also various materials from MIT site also. Follow. Yeah, coming back to the selection sort, that is one of the stupidest algorithm I have told. And then the insertion sort is better, because insertion sort base case is O(n). Now quickly review this, then the divide and conquer policy, I say that is the best. And even in the merge sort, you divide by half, you get the log n advantage, n log n. Even if you don't divide exactly by half, any divide is always the advantage. Like we will see in team sort, may not divide into half. It may divide at not actual equal, maybe larger part and smaller part, but there also will get some advantage. Definitely n log n type of advantage will get. That is a team sort. That is divide and conquer is always there, because whenever you divide, you can allocate the process to another CPU and all. You'll get the advantage. Yeah, now I'm coming back to the what are the uncomputable problems. We are reaching from O(n), O(n) square, n log n, O(n) log n, n square, matrix multiplication, maybe O(n) cube. Then yesterday we have covered that is exponential problem, that is 2 to the power n problems like Dick's problem, Tower of Hanoi problem. Then we have discussed, we have missed one more problem, that is prime number, getting prime number, generating prime number, that is also not easily available problem like ANN square problem. And also, if you multiply 7 into 9, 63 is good, it is pretty simple, but whenever you want to factorize a big number, very big number, maybe odd number, that doesn't look apparently to prime number, whether how many prime numbers, whether the number is actually prime, and whether the how many factors are there, that is a really computationally challenging problem. That is not an n square problem. That is a problem of very computationally tough, and that is the problem of our security bedrock of RSA security and all. We need to have two very pretty big large numbers. We want to have some their product. Then we can to factorize a big number, product of two big prime number, maybe 256 bit prime number or 512 bit, and then to again to find it out reversely is tough, really tough. So that's it. So that is one kind of problem we'll face. That is a tough problem, because what is a tough problem? Whenever I started my engineering career, I bought a Casio calculator. Probably you all have a calculator. Then we found that what is a tough problem? Everything can be solved within a second and all this. But whenever you really study computer science, there's a lots fine tougher problems are there, which are really very easy to appear, but it's really tough. Yeah, so that is a prime number. Factorization is one of the tough problems I missed last class. User prime numbers, I've told you, large prime means it's cryptography. And RSA is three scientist names are there. This is the basic bedrock of the algorithm, so that two big prime numbers product is used, and it is assumed that to get factorization of the prime number is pretty difficult. Yeah, another problem I have is to discuss the traveling salesman problem. That is the picture. Here you see the total number of combinations. Say if there are n number of edges, all are connected by a path, the total number of solutions may be n minus 1 factorial. And if we do not take this direction or this direction all are same, then divided by 2. So this is really comes from your combination formula, n minus 1, and then you have to take the minimum value of it. And you see, for if there are 50 customers to visit a traveling salesman, total number of solution is factorial 49 divided by 2. So that is a pretty huge number. So you see that your 50 customers, some component of 50 goes to the power of 10, not 2. So this is definitely tougher problem than Tower of Hanoi. So this is one class of problem, but we try to solve it in different techniques. So this is, at least you should be aware of, this is one kind of problem. So brute force solution like selection sort, maybe O factorial n, but by dynamic programming, by divide and conquer technique, not like Marsh sort, different divide and conquer, we may get solution. So O n square 2 to the power n, that is a much less number than this, but these things will be you discuss your algorithm classes, not here, but we, at least we should be aware of these are the tough problems, and we need a machine, we need a formal language to simulate that machine, how this computation can be done. That is the interesting idea. Another problem I have told, it is Nash scheduling problem. This I have borrowed it from Columbian Engineering. Now it is very prevalent in COVID-19 days. In any hospitals, there are only limited number of nurses. They cannot be given three duties together. Maybe day shift and night shift can be combined, and all these things, permutation and combination, you need. It is also a very tough problem. Maybe factorial n problem. It is definitely tougher than a Tower of Hanoi problem. That is a scheduling problem. That is one description of knapsack problem. I'll come to this. What is knapsack problem? Yeah, that is a knapsack problem. This is one of the toughest problem you have. See, if you are really get into a vault of any bank and you have lots of materials are available of a thief, or if one assumed to be thief, then you have a bag with a limited weight and there's a value. So there are many numbers of weights are there and values are there, target is there. How to get your maximize your value in this bag? That is a knapsack problem. This is a typical problem, again the factorial n, and we'll come across this kind of problem. Another version of knapsack problem is there, maybe there are more than only one copies are available, and if it's more than one copy, there are various solutions. So there are various version of man knapsack problem, only one item or more than one item. Actually, within your bag is limited with 15 kgs, and how to get it the maximum value. Remember, this knapsack problem comes everywhere in the industry. Say in airlines, whenever you're loading traffic, when cargoes, in ship, whenever you're loading cargoes, and a lot of cases, this knapsack problem is coming, and these are the really competition or tough problem. Yeah, then these are the tough problem. Then we're going to undecidable problem. There we don't have enough algorithm till today, and we'll discuss with this. We enter class here. So we really discuss the various complexity classes of algorithm, and we need a machine, we need a programming language. Programming is nothing, language is nothing but a just an extended version of formal language. And formal language is there to write an algorithm. So that is interesting course we try to cover in automata and formal language area. Thank you for hearing.